Oh, sorry, I got engrossed in the key. Hey folks, how's everyone doing? Not so long ago, we had two type of cars in the luxury segment. You had the driver-oriented cars and then you had the Sage G-oriented cars. Now the driver-oriented cars did not excite the Sage Gs and the Sage G-oriented cars, they did not excite the drivers for obvious reasons. The Sage G-oriented cars had enough of legroom at the rear but were not enjoyable behind the steering wheel, and the steering wheel enjoyable cars did not have the enough legroom at the rear. Point in case here, I'm talking about the 5 series and the E-class of then. So you had this distinctive customers. You had people who loved to drive, they picked up the 5 series, and people who loved the comfort, they picked up the E-class. And then the Škoda Superb came in, and the Superb was actually a superb car, and that is where the E-class fell in problem, because anybody and everybody who went to the Mercedes showroom and they wanted to check out the E-class, they always felt that the E-class was not now up there with the legroom that Superb offered. So a lot of E-class customers ended up going to the Škoda Superb. That is where Mercedes-Benz thought, now is the time to up the game. And that's how when they relaunched the new E-class, they got the long wheelbase version, especially for India. Now with problems solved for Mercedes-Benz, the sales starts on fire for Mercedes-Benz, especially for the E-class. The problem for BMW started, because now suddenly anybody and everybody who wanted to buy an 80 lakh car was rushing towards the Mercedes-Benz dealership to pick up the E-Class, and the 5 series, in spite of the potent engine, had limited sales, all thanks to it being only driver oriented. And BMW had to think quick on their feet, and what they thought quickly on their feet is the all new product that they got in India, which was the 6 GT. Yes, the 6 GT was a perfect combination of driver and perfect combination of rear seat comfort. Now, in 2021, Mercedes-Benz has gone ahead and updated the E-Class with some mechanical changes and some facelift over here and there. And BMW also has responded with the new 6 Series, the 6 GT. That is what we have today for the review with us. Welcome all to MW TV. My name is Nilesh. Do subscribe to our channel, hit that bell icon so that you get notified on our next videos. And I insist do check out our Instagram channel, because we have some great content coming there. And to all those who love reading, we do have our website live now. Do check that out too. The URL there is www.mwtv.in. You will definitely fall in love with our content. And if you love the content, don't forget to register so that you get notified whenever a new content comes up, whether it's on the YouTube or whether it's on the website. Now, let's have a look at the car. The updated 6 GT now has become far more chiseled and far more sharper. Having said that, the front profile is reminiscent of any other BMW. Just that now, the bumpers have got sharper, the headlamps have got sleeker, and they now house a BMW laser adaptive lights which have a throw of up to 650 meters. And the kidney grille, as usual, sports active aerodynamics which open and shut basis the machinery requirements. What BMW has eliminated in the facelift is the LED fog lamps which used to be present in the earlier version. They were there next to these air dams here. What we have for the review is the sportier 630D. With the M Sport trim. That comes with sportier bumper, aggressively designed side skirts, bigger 19-inch alloys, and aggressive brakes. From the front, the 5 and 6 GT bear a very similar face, and it is hard to tell them both apart by looking at their face. Moving to the sides, this is where the difference begins. The longer wheelbase over the 5 gives a clear idea of the space what 6 GT has on the inside. The roof merges down into the boot, giving it a coupe-like look from the side. The 19-inch rims on the M Sport look good and give the car a meatier stance. The frameless doors add to the character of the 6 Series GT, and this is one very cool thing to have, and that is what I love about the 6 GTs. The 6 GT is a pretty long car. The overall length has gone up by 150 meters as compared to the 5 Series. While the wheelbase stands at 3070 millimeters. Coming to the rear, the all LED tail lamps now with a pronounced 3D effect, give a sportier character to the car. The rear bumper sports a diffuser which adds a dash of class and sportier appeal to the car. GTI stands for Gran Turismo, that means it is designed to take you and your family from place A to place B in utmost comfort. And that is where the boot space becomes absolutely important. Happy to report that the GT comes with 1800 liters of boot space with all the seats folded down. But then there is a problem. The problem here really is this space saver tire, which takes up most of the space in your boot. Overall, therefore, the 6 GT on the outside gives an extremely sporty character to the car, and the sporty you who loves their cars to look sporty will definitely love the 6 GT. Now that we have explored the car from the outside and have seen that the car is extremely sporty, let's now step inside to see how comfortable the car is from the inside and will it also excite the said G in you. Let's go in. Step inside and you are greeted to modern interiors that you are used to seeing in other BMWs today. The dashboard, just as any other BMW, is driver centric. It now gets a bigger 12.25 inch center screen, which is absolutely intuitive to use. It comes with satellite navigation and BMW's much famed gesture control. The ID.7 derived driver instrument console is all digital, which has a love it or hate it kind of a look. The display changes basis the mode that you choose to be in, and the different menus can be toggled on the right hand side of the display. The front seats are well bolstered, the cushioning is soft, and the electronic thigh extenders work perfectly well to give you additional comfort on those long drives. The iDrive, as always, is extremely intuitive to use, and it can be controlled by the scroller next to the gear knob or the buttons on the steering wheel, or simply at the use of voice commands. The storage space below the central console houses the wireless charging pad, which also wirelessly pairs the iPhone for CarPlay as well as the Android Auto. The ambient lighting in the 6 GT is more pronounced, just as the 530D, with similar 6 dimmable color options to suit every individual taste and needs. Talking about the in-car entertainment system, it consists of a 12.25 inch screen for the iDrive. The iDrive acts as a brain for many features inside this cabin, including the audio setup. Powering this is the 16-speaker, 600 watts, high-end surround system from Harman Kardon, which boasts of high-fidelity sound. The bass is richer and deeper, and unlike other systems, it does not distort the vocals or the mids. In short, whether you're listening to the Ghazals or retro or EDM, the music is going to sound good. Since the BMW 6 GT is all about the rear, let's now talk about that. Open the large doors and you see how spacious the car is. There's acres of legroom, and headroom is more than sufficient despite the coupe styling. The windows are large and get electric sunblinds. The panoramic sunroof adds an extremely airy feel, and BMW has done well by adding 4-zone climate control and a rear entertainment screen. The rear seats are super comfy, and the backrests can be adjusted electronically too. Of course, the recline angle is not as much as what you get in the E-Class. The headrests get pillows that are super soft and feel luxurious. Overall, the BMW 6 GT is a great place to be in. Never will you feel that there is less space anywhere, and the sage in you will be comfortable, and the driver in you will also love being behind the wheel. Now that we have explored how comfortable the interiors are of this BMW 6 GT, let me now get behind the wheel and tell you how it is to drive. Over to the driving seat now. BMW offers the 6 series with 3 engine options. You have the 2-litre petrol, you have the 2-litre diesel, and then you have the 3-litre straight 6 diesel over here, and that is what this 630D is all about. We have
265 horsepower and 620 newton meter torque, which is enough to pull this car from 0 to 100 in just 6.5 seconds. Just 6.5. How is it to drive then? But before I come there on how is it to drive, I really want to put the gearbox in perspective. BMW offers a ZF sourced 8-speed torque converter unit in this 6 series. Trust me, this 8-speed gearbox here, which is ZF sourced, is lightning quick and even quicker than the DSGs. Now that's something, because traditionally torque converters were never as fast as DSGs, and I just don't know what BMW does, but this car shifts gears in milliseconds. The engine, the gearbox responds to your command and it just places a wide grin on your face. Now talking about the handling. The 6 GT is longer and wider than the 5 series. It also additionally comes with the air suspensions. While both the cars have similar engine and similar gearbox tuning, the handling characteristics in both the cars is different. The 6 GT, owing to its length and width and the air suspensions, is slightly wobbly as compared to 5 series, even if when it is in the sportiest mode. However, even in comfort mode, you will have those rumbling strips felt inside. Talking about the ride has become extremely supple. The seat G sitting behind is not going to get disturbed with what the driver does here. Of course, unless the driver is in the Sport Plus mode. Put the car in comfort and the car will absolutely glide over everything. Put the car in sport, the car becomes aggressive.
There are quite a few driving modes to choose from in the 630D. There's Eco Pro, Comfort, Comfort Plus, Sport, Sports Plus and Adaptive. Rather it is Sport. The Eco Pro helps in extracting that extra bit of fuel which might help you save some money. But you'll have to sacrifice drivability for that. For the city drives, comfort mode goes about doing the job really well. It controls the 265 horsepower aggression well and helps you maintain pace with start-stop traffic. What Comfort Plus mode does over the comfort mode is it further softens down the suspension and it gives you that carpet-like ride quality. Out on the highway, switch to the sport mode and this beast leaps forward like nobody's business. The moment you switch to Sport Plus mode, the beast unleashes the true potential of this 265 horsepower that you have and it plasters a wide grin on your face. However, if these things are extremely confusing for you, switch in simply into adaptive mode and the car will do the job for you. You are in traffic, it will shift to eco mode. You are on the highway, it will shift to adaptive or sport plus mode basis your throttle inputs.
While the 6 series is fun behind the wheel, but I have one problem, and that problem is this wide A-pillar. This A-pillar obstructs your vision and sometimes it keeps you in blank when somebody is closing in or passing through. However, having said that, yes, while the A-pillars are wider, but what BMW has done is they have given 360 degree cameras in this car which allow you to park the car comfortably, confidently, and also steer the car confidently and comfortably in traffic.
We had ran a very interesting poll on our Insta channel and we had asked our audience there their choice between updated 5 series and the 6 GT. And the 6 GT had won that poll hands down. And I now know why. Because 6 GT is a perfect combination of the Seju you who loves to sit behind from Mondays to Fridays and a perfect combination for the driver who loves to be behind the control on Saturdays. If that is what you love, we can with guarantee tell you that this 6GT is going to excite you. So on that note, thank you for watching this video till the end. And if you are looking for some exclusive offers on this 6GT anywhere that you are in India, write to us at hello@mwtv.in. Our team will get back to you with the best offers and best prices for this 6GT. On that note, signing off. Take care. See you in our next video. Bye-bye.